Let's save again. Okay, who we are? We have here. Okay, we have also those two. Ugh, goddammit. Ongzel medicine isn't working either. Is it the same thing they say? Can't remember. Yep, still nothing. Still have money, but. Nope. So let's search about something else. Oh no, this is something different. Yeah, but nothing for us. Oh well. We'll watch you back. Be thankful. Let's see if France has something different. Natalia must be aware that Ivan is infected. Yeah, so why is she still following him? Good question. Maybe she just can't betray him, no matter what. Why? Isn't she the one being betrayed? Alfred, you'll see real. You're really still a child. Natalia is Ivan's ally through and through. I don't think she will resign herself without a fight. Either way, it's complicated. Okay, we can proceed. You came to see me? You came to see me? There's no one else to protect this place, so I can't go too far. I was getting really bored. Ivan. Well, when don't we play? Come here, Natalia. Ivan, stand back. Natalia, Ivan is being controlled by the error. Even you can see that, right? Even so, I am my brother's ally. As long as my body moves, as long as my body can move, I will protect him. Let's go. Natalia! Okay. Let's start the new skills. Oh yeah, that's... Okay. Bad. Yeah. Oh gosh. Well, we can still revive him with him. Yeah. Should be good. Well, it lacks very so much. I already did a bad job at planning battles and all. Whatever. Okay. Let's do the skills. And perfect. Should be good. Ivan. Natalia! You did your best, Natalia. I'll take care of them now, so you just rest, okay? Ivan. I was actually a little worried that she'd end up. I was actually a little worried that she'd end up defeating you. Now it's finally my turn. Let's go! Winter! We're doomed! We're doomed now! He's too strong for us. Shit. If we could hear Ludwig and the others.
Hey, aren't you going to... Hey, aren't you going to try again? If you won't make the first move, then I will.
Natalia!
I am my brother's ally, not your enemy.
Natalia! Hey, hang in there! Francis, heal her! Hurry, before the arrow gets there!
Natalia? Why? What have I done?
You lowered your guard, even. We'll help your sister. We'll help your sister, don't worry.
Let's do this, Wes.
Come on now! Hurry up and destroy that thing!
How are they?
Still in a coma. We healed their injuries, but it looks like their mother have been damaged somehow. We think it's because they were infected for too long.
Right now, the lives are in danger. We just have no idea when they'll wake up.
I see.
Eva, why? Everyone, good job.
You sound pretty tired, Kiku.
Yes, I have been verifying the condition non-stop. I haven't had any rest or sleep. I must have drunk about 100 Lipovitans by now.
I wonder what those are. Probably so, like a drink with sugar and coffee. I know that in Japan, in a vending machine they have, right, like, really strange stuff, but it doesn't matter right now.
But I have both potions. Even if it is not much, it should be enough for me to recover.
Kiku, that's dangerous. He's getting high from exhaustion.
So, did you figure anything out?
Yes. First, about the condition of those three. In Ivan's case, there's no doubt that it is due to the fact that... In Ivan's case, there's no doubt that it is due to the fact of infection by the arrow.
I think the most likely cause for his non-exhaustion is that he was forced to use teleportation and other abilities than his own.
But be that as it may, Ivan himself is refusing to wake up.
Refusing?
Why is that?
He's not infected anymore, is he?
I don't know why. He certainly shouldn't be infected anymore, but his configuration program is still very unstable.
Next, about Feliciano and Rovina.
Who was controlling them?
Is there something beside the arrow?
I'm sorry, I'm still investigating about that. First, we'd rather verify their condition.
Are they also refusing to wake up?
Well, it seems that because of their mental exhaustion, it's essentially the same as Ivan's. But the difference between them and the Ivan is that their programs are very stable. I wouldn't be surprised if it took them a long time to wake up, though. In any case, that is all I've been able to figure out so far.
How is the arrow doing right now?
He hasn't made any move. It's rather uncanny.
Yeah, it's weird that he didn't even try to interfere.
Indeed. I kept watching him just in case, but...
He didn't move even when he went to destroy the energy sources.
There must be something else, then.
Back on topic. If they wake up as it is, then it won't be a problem. But if they remain in a comatose state, even if you eliminate the arrow, they won't be able to return to this world.
Then, it's the same as if they become part of this world, right?
Exactly. Ivan, in particular, will be in grave danger if his unstable condition goes on. Sorry for that.
Honda, what can I do? How can I help him?
Please, calm down. I didn't say there was no way to help him. The teleshifter I delivered to Ludwig.
Oh, yes.
It's a drastic measure, but with a teleshifter, you can dive into Ivan's subconscious and physically eliminate the cause of the problem.
What?
Is that even possible?
You mean dive into my brother's heart? Natalia, that's not quite what I meant. As long as you're in that world, you exist as data. Just as I am able to speak into your program from here, I should also be able to personally dive into it from there. Theoretically. We have absolutely no privacy in this world, do we?
I think I'm afraid of this world for the first time since I came here.
It's alright. I can look into your subconscious if you're awake, unfortunately. And even if I could, I wouldn't look, probably.
Well, if you say so. Well, if you say so.
Into my brother's heart. Into my brother's. Honda, tell me how to get there. As long as you have the teleshifter, you don't have to do anything. I can transfer you from there, from here. However, it is a very delicate program, so I can only transfer two people at most. That's good enough. I'll go alone.
Alone? That's way too dangerous!
It's no problem. I won't let you bastards get into my brother's heart.
It's not quite his heart, though.
Be that as it may, you have to consider Eros' intervention and even some resistance. I really wouldn't recommend going alone.
No lady can go through such a danger all alone. I should go with.
What if my brother turns into a pervert and freak because of you? I don't trust you. I'll go alone.
Please, take me with you.
What are you talking about? It's too dangerous.
I'll be fine. I have this gun that you gave me.
Then I'll go instead.
Please, let me go, Vash. If you were in the same condition as Ivan, I certainly will go and help you without stopping to think about... If you were in the same condition as Ivan, I certainly will go and help you without stopping to think about the risks. As someone who also has a brother, I can't just leave Natalia alone. Natalia, can I go with you?
Yeah.
Thank you.
And the ship has sailed.
No, just no. If you want, I'll go. You just wait for me.
Vash. Let her go.
Sorry for throwing my blanket on it, but diving to one's subconscious is a great responsibility, so it is necessary to constantly adjust the program during the dive. In other words, I won't be able to watch the error at the same time. It's also highly possible, that the protective walls that have might get destroyed.
That's also worrisome.
There aren't any other energy sources for the error, right?
There shouldn't be, but it's still a little too early to relax.
How long is this cutscene?
Okay. I might as well just cut it here. Stay tuned for the next part.
Roderick, get out of my way.
We're telling you to get out of the way, you bastard!
What is wrong with you two?
Arthur, Francis, get changed first.
But I don't want to move. I'm listening, so can I just stay here?
Negative.